Alright, welcome back to the crew, too. I kinda cut the last video out, or episode 1. Yeah, I cut the video out before, I even got back to this place, but anyways, this is basically like, the garage or whatever. I don't know if this can be changed, or if this is just the one you have to stay with. Maybe in the full game you'll be able to get another one or more, multiple, I don't know. But for right now, this is the only one I know of. And yeah, I've made some changes to the Mustang. I haven't progressed at all with any races yet, but I've done a little bit of customization. Basically, I added a rear bumper, I added side skirts, changed the mirrors, the interior, and the front bumper. I believe that's it. So yeah, nothing else really to show in here. It's basically just where you can walk around, keep all your cars. The trailer for the game, I believe, is just constantly being played on this TV, which is pretty cool. But, yeah. I'm gonna go out for a drive and continue the street racing story, or whatever it is. So yeah, this is also how the map works. It's pretty cool how the map works. It's a huge map. I drove from Miami all the way to New York, and it took a while, so yeah, this map's pretty big. It's gonna take a very long time just to drive all the way around it, so fast travel is definitely the best option here. In Miami, there's no street races? No. So I'm gonna have to fast travel to New York. If I can, correct? Can I? Where is it? And open. Alright, so just travel to. Okay, here we go. And that was. Whoa, that was really fast. Alright, that's the fastest fast travel I've ever experienced. There's two casual cars. Excuse me? Excuse me?
More importantly, who doesn't want to race? That's what you're going to get to do on a closed course Wrangler just for us. It's a dream race, so go enjoy and win.
Classic challenge. Alright, oh wait, what? Go to the starting grid. Hold up a sec. Oh, whoa, okay, I gotta go in here. Whoops. Confused me a little for a second. Anyways, I'm here. Alright, oh. So is everyone else in a classic and I'm not? It won't even give me a loner classic, really? Come on now. I mean, I didn't really have the option to take a classic, so... So yeah, things start pretty quickly. You don't have to wait very long. Like, it's not like Forza or Need for Speed with these big loading times and loading screens or anything like that. And it definitely doesn't take as long to fast travel, that's for sure. Fast travel is basically instant. You just choose where you want to go, say travel to, and then boom, you're just there. I recently uploaded the full car list, so I might save this to upload for tomorrow. I don't know. I don't know if there's a difficulty setting in this game, but it seems pretty difficult right now. Maybe that's just me still needing to get used to the game, but, because I'm still not that great with the handling. I mean, I don't know if it's just the Mustang or what it is. I added some performance upgrades as well. I added a gearbox and suspension. And I don't want any of these tracks yet, obviously, because I haven't played the game. It's the first time playing. I knew about the shortcut this time. Yeah, jumps are also very weird. I don't think the jumping physics make a lot of sense. Because, like, I just went over that jump right then and just, like, sucked me right back down to the ground. And I did it while I was doing a little bit of exploration as well. And the same thing basically happened. Alright. Either I can't turn or the Mustang can't turn. I have no idea. Either one is probably
that's how you do it.
Okay. Either one could be true. It's either me or the Mustang. Okay, yep. That time it was me. Come on, hurry up and end this race. Well, I'm actually in the lead for once. Alright, here we go. Alright, so I actually won a race. I'm still not used to this whole drive afterwards thing. I'm used to the game taking over, but whatever. 13,500 bucks. Or whatever.
You should grab it. I'm sure it's gonna come in handy. The loot consists of parts you can use to upgrade your rides. So keep bringing it in.
Alright.
Ah, something. Up till now, we've only gotten green loot, but other colored loot.
I just got something blue.
Stuff.
What are you talking about? Okay, whatever. But, yeah, something very annoying so far that I've discovered is that if you're driving around and just free roaming, exploring, this annoying voice guy will just keep talking to you saying, oh, hey, you realize you can do races and all that, right? And I'm just like, yes, obviously. Yeah, you just won't shut up until you actually do something. Oh yeah, this thing also, this radar, helps you find, like, more performance parts and things like that. Now, I don't know where this one would be. Maybe it's in here? I don't know. I'm still getting closer. It's like right here. What? Am I supposed to be looking at this? Nope, I guess not. I guess it's on the other side of this building? I don't know. So, realistically, it should be over here somewhere. Oh, yeah, here it is. Alright. Gearbox and suspension. I already have those on this car. Right, I'm probably going to edit out most of that because it took longer than it should have. But anyways, let's see. Oh, yeah, something else pretty cool that it does. It follows your tracks on the map. So I'll try to show right here. Yeah, you can... Wait a sec. Yeah, like basically, these little trails, it's nighttime now, so it's hard to see, but wherever you go, the map shows, you know, where you've been, basically, and it shows your exact path, so that's pretty cool as well. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Still getting used to the whole map and whatnot. So I already did that. And what else is there to do? There's one in Las Vegas and Los Angeles. Street Racing HQ. The Sleeper. I'll just go to this one first. I haven't been anywhere over on this side of the map. Other than in the intro, I think. So let's travel to. Okay, this is taking longer because it's a further distance, but it's still a very quick, fast travel. And, yeah, I guess it's just all in parking garages, so...
Right here is where Teal, the champion, made his bones. If you win here, it's damn certain you're going to attract his attention.
Alright, so let's just drive into a parking garage and then go with the start grid, which here we are. Hey, it's me!
Three, two,
someone's copying Mustang, man.
One.
All right, here we go.
Welcome to a day of family-friendly entertainment.
Again, I'm still forgetting that there's a whole boost thing, but getting used to that now. Yeah, the handling in this Mustang's really weird. I don't know if that's just the game's handling or the way the Mustang okay. Well, I didn't know I couldn't go through here. Alright, so there's a Stang that's copying me. So where am I going? Okay. I don't know if that should slow me down that much, but whatever. more jumps and it just sucks you right back down. Physics, again, doesn't make a lot of sense. Now, I know that gravity's a thing, but this is not how gravity works. Like, you're going down a lot faster than you should. Oh, get out of here. That's what you get for copying me. Oh, and he's back just like that. Okay. I love how it just wastes all the boost because the wheels keep spinning and I won't change gears. And I know you'll probably just say, oh, switch to manual, but I think I want to get used to the game a little more before I do that. It's basically the same with Forza. You know, I start out with... Well, I mean, I won't now because I'm used to Forza games. Oh, look, I did it again because I don't realize I have to turn there. Whatever. All right. Turn where I'm trying to turn. I'm just going to focus a little bit here. Try and catch this wiper. Stop spinning. Alright, here we go. First, finally. See, eventually I probably will switch to manual. Okay, come on now. What is that? Wait, where am I? Is there a way to rewind, like, honestly? I don't understand. Like, really, I didn't see this turn. Okay, that's bullshit. That is bullshit right there. Like, oh no, what is this? Well, I'm gonna have to do this again. Yeah, that was really stupid. First place, and all of a sudden it's just like, oh no, you're supposed to turn here. Okay, well, it would have been nice to know. There goes the Viper again. Alright, better start than last time. Like, what is that for a turn? Alright, so this is the first stop. Oh, what is that? What is that? Really? I can't see, and then the jump is, like, leading me over towards that. Are you serious? That is also bullshit. Like, the glare makes me cannot be able to see. And the ramps are... Like, I thought that I was going straight over the ramps, but I guess not. This is also what messed me up, because I couldn't see the signs telling me to turn this way. I absolutely hate it when it cuts out. Like, why can't it just record past 15 minutes? Like, it can live stream past 15 minutes, so why can't it record past 15 minutes? I got a big bit to edit out anyways. Why are you spinning that much? Come on. Right now. See, like, that ramp is so misleading. Alright, now don't forget this turn. See, like, this is what should happen in the first race, but apparently not. Okay, now I don't like going this way, but whatever. And there we go. That was a lot easier than the first time around, and that should have happened the first time around. Oh, it wrecked, dude. Alright, so I have a lot more money now. So yeah, making money, definitely not a problem. Wait, let me get this stuff. So what did I get now? Brakes, motor core, gearbox, and rear bumper. Alright, well, I'm going to stop recording now, go back to the shop or garage, whatever it is, and add some more customization to actually record it this time. Something else I find pretty cool is when you're looking at a race after you've completed it, you don't just see the outline of the race. You actually see the path, the exact paths that you've driven. Like, for example, you can see all the times I accidentally drove through here. And, of course, when I accidentally went left instead of right and had to do this big old U-turn right here. So, yeah, you basically... It just shows all the paths you've followed in the race, I guess, because I've done this race twice. And you can see one time I really overshot that turn. And you can also see the long way or the shortcuts. Like, I've taken both ways. This is a long way and this is a shortcut. So, yeah, that's also pretty cool. It doesn't just show you the outline of the race. It shows you all the paths that you've taken. Alright, back in the garage. It actually didn't take very long to fast travel here at all. So let me customize. Let me see the visual part I have unlocked. It was a rear bumper. So, okay, it's this one with like the center exhaust. No, I'd rather stick with the one that I already have bought. So now, I also have another visual part. I don't know which one it is, but we have brakes. We have a new motor core and more suspension. So this suspension is better by far, so throw that on. Motor core, oh, we got two blue ones. Let's throw the best one on. Gearbox, there's a lot of gearboxes, we'll throw on the 170. And brakes, we'll throw on the 127, and that's it. I'm not really going to look at what it does, I'm just going to throw on the best one for now. It's only the beta, so it doesn't really matter. And there's a visual part that I missed, and it's another rear bumper. Okay, so I own this one with the rear canards. Thing is, I don't really know if I want the canards, you know? Like, if I get the canards, I'm going to have to add a bunch of other things, you know? Well, I'll do it. Why not? Alright, so I still have one owned. Do I have to equip it first or no? No, I don't know. It still says I own one thing, but I don't know. Yeah, like, what is it? Which one do I have? Let me just go through all of them. I don't know, maybe it's just a glitch. That's what I'm gonna assume. Alright, so anyways. Hood. I want something crazy for the hood. Like, I want a blower, but I don't know if I want it black or orange. I like the carbon fiber, but I don't know if I want, like, the full carbon fiber hood. So, yeah, I think I'm going to go with the black vents with the black blower. Buy that, because I don't have any CCs, whatever that is. I guess it's currency that you can buy. But I don't really feel like there's a point. Okay, rims. We'll change these up. A lot of options for rims here. I don't know what I want to go with. Like, those are fine, but I want to go with more of a muscly look, you know? I mean, those are alright, but I don't know. Definitely nothing like that. I mean, those are cool, but those are more so ones that you'd find on a Skyline or something. Actually, no, six spoke would be the one. Yeah, like something like this would be on a Skyline. Oh, here we go. This is fine. Yeah, I'll take these. Now, color. I don't really want anything stupid like this. I'll black them out a little bit. Rim size, now I don't want to go too crazy, you know. I'll just go about halfway with both. Yeah, I'll go about halfway with both of them. Why those? Caliper color, I already got that done. Side mirrors, I already got that done. Side skirts, I already got that. Rear wing. Let's see, I don't know if I want this or if I want this. Like, this is just going full Santa crazy. But this is like, this is alright, this is like cool. I don't know. You know what, I'll just go with this for now. If I want to change it, I'll just change it. Now, interior color, already got that all done. Rear bumper, so front bumper. Should I keep it the same, or should I go with front canards as well? This is a bit crazy. This is a bit too crazy for me, but I kind of want to do it. Yeah, we're going to go for it. Whatever. Why not? Now, I believe that's all there is for customization on this car, at least. Yeah, so we're going to be keeping it like this. I don't really know if I want to add any livery or whatnot or change the color. But this is fun for now. Alright, so that will be episode 2 concluded. We got a bit of customization in. We got a few races and whatnot. So yeah, if anyone actually is watching this, do you like the customization? Is it too crazy? Do you want it turned down a bit? Or since it's the beta, do you want to just go full send? And, yeah, I know you can't tint the windows, or can you? Hold on a second. Wait, what's that? Window. Okay, you can just roll the windows down. Okay, anything else that you can do? Turn the lights on? Okay. So you can do all kinds of things. Wait, can I pop the hood? This is a big one. Can I pop the hood? By the looks of it, that is a no. Which kind of sucks. You can open the doors, though. Wait, can I get in it? Can I get in? Seat. Okay, I can get in. Nice. Yeah, I didn't even know about this. I can turn the wheel. Start engine. Now, can I rev it up or nah? Oh, I can. Alright, nice. Wait, wipers? You can even work the wipers. Yeah, I didn't even notice that either. Alright, whatever. Well, we're learning something new every day. I didn't know that. Can you open this passenger? Nope, can't open the passenger door. So that's basically all you can do with that. You can't pop the hood or the trunk or anything like that. But you can get in it, start it up, rev it up. So yeah, this is cool. We're learning new things every day. So now this really is going to conclude episode number 2. Let me just close the door. There we go. And yeah, as always, don't forget to drive safe, people, and I'm out.